Greetings, Eric Becker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back for 2018, checking out my videos. I've got a whole lot of stuff planned for this year. And as usual, got many questions from people from, 50, 60, 70 countries. It's awesome to see all the subscribers coming in now asking different questions. But please remember, I can't physically answer all the questions that are posed to me on YouTube. I get 50, 60, 70 questions per day. It's impossible for me to answer physically all of the questions. So I'm going to keep trying to pick out different questions from my subscriber base and reply to those through videos. It's the best way to do it because then everyone's got access. Please also make sure that you check out the playlists. We've got close to 1,000 videos now in many different playlists. There's bound to be a video answering a question that you're probably going to want to know the answer to. So please check out the playlists on this channel. I've got some questions here from a lady in Canada called Helen. Helen wants to know what cutaneous candida is. She's saying, Eric, please explain to me about cutaneous candida. So cutaneous candida is skin-based yeast infection. There are many different types of yeast that can potentially afflict the skin, not just candida. There's also geotrichum, trichosporum, many other yeasts with weird and strange-sounding names like that. So the key areas that we're going to find cutaneous or a skin-based candida problem will be in the areas where it's dark and it's moist and it's warm. It's like the folds of the skin around the belly area for, slightly larger people. It could be under the breasts. It could be for some people between, the fingers, like the webs here. It could be around the toes or the toenails, those sorts of areas. It could be the groin. It could be inside the ears. These are all key areas where a yeast infection can really take off, especially if the person's sweaty and hot. So summertime, we tend to find this more than the wintertime, for example. The warmer climates, we're going to find it more than the cooler climates. I've seen advertisements on the TV here in Australia and in New Zealand. Every summertime they do this, they advertise this particular powder that you can puff around the body, basically to kill a yeast infection on the skin. So cutaneous candida is skin-based yeast infection. The more common places we're going to find it around the genital area, the private areas, for male and female. We're going to also commonly find it, for example, around the feet. People who wear socks, especially in the warmer climate. I've seen lots of people in many different industries over the years. The people I find who've got the worst yeast problems are the ones who wear rubber boots. For example, people who wear on dairy farms. We've got a lot of dairy farms in New Zealand. So I've seen some shocking yeast infections of people who, for example, milking cows, because their feet are kept moist all the time. We could also get it with people who work in plants, like processing, like food processing, we see it. I also see it in people who work in meat works, like boners or butchers. I've seen it in people who do welding, mechanical work, who wear, coveralls or overalls. They're going to have a lot of moisture, to the body. I've seen it in some people on construction sites who wear hard hats. I've seen it around the ears and in the ears. People wear earmuffs quite a lot. I've seen it with airport workers. I've seen all kinds of people over the many years. So people who wear those big headphones, to stop noises, aircraft and stuff, they can be more prone to that inside the ear. So you can get it anywhere on the surface of the skin. So that's what it is. Cutaneous candida is skin-based yeast infection. Check out the other videos in this series. I'm going to talk about symptoms, I'm going to talk about causes, I'm going to talk about treatments, I'm going to go into a lot more. Thanks for tuning in.